You know, what do you think the real problem is with Africa? I mean, you have so many things on the table, like colonial hypnosis or banking problems or government problems or just, you know.
I think we have to go for the step that every civilization have taken to get to the point where they are today. And they have had the European have had the worst leaders ever. I mean, Julius Caesar is not an angel. I mean, what happened in his family is beyond words, being killed by your own kids. And we just, Africans, have to realize that we are not monsters. Monsters have been around in this history. And that Africa have been, from the beginning, in, at its core heart, been beaten, bled to death. When you take away men and women that can build your wealth, to build other people's wealth, it takes centuries to rebuild that. Not only takes centuries to rebuild it, it takes centuries to heal the wounds on both parts, which is not going to be easy, because there is a kind of a willingness of amnesia about slavery. And I think it's the interest of the slavers and the one that sold their brothers and sisters to keep it like that. It's not going to happen. Gotta come out. For us to move forward in Africa, we have to dig deep into our responsibility, make our mea culpa, and our way for the rich country to realize that they were as criminal as the one that sold them human being. You can't tell me when you buy a human being, they don't know what you're doing. Mm. So therefore, for me, it's beyond reparation.
Yeah. Your money can't pay for that, can it?
Money cannot pay for that. It's how you use the same machinery of destroying the African, the black people's image, you use that same to rehabilitate it and tell your people you've been wrong, you've done wrong, that the house they have, the street they have, everything they have been built by those black people that they disrespect.
Those Wall Streets and all those other places.
Absolutely. Mm. That's why that the work of amnesia from the powerful countries is so deeply engraved in the situation of today. That's why if that comes out and apologies have to be done and rehabilitation have to be made, they can't anymore go back and take our wealth away from us the way they do it.
Yeah.
They can't use our debt to play against us.
Yeah.
So, Africans have their responsibilities, but the rich country have theirs too.
Yeah.
Everybody have to take part of their responsibility. Blaming game have to stop.
Because we can't wait for those rich countries to do anything for us, can we? It's never happened, so it's never going to happen.
Never going to happen. Unless we push them to.
Right.
And in order to push them to do that, we have to be more organized. And we are not. Because the roots of divide to conquer
still
is really deeply rooted in Africa.
It's really powerful, isn't it?
It is powerful.